So the lower jaw plan is full teeth extraction and implant.
Okay.
So we are planning for eight implants. So four on this side, four on this side.
Okay.
So how to distribute the four is, there are two options.
Okay.
One is place two before the mental foramen and after the mental foramen. Two here and two in the molar. That is one option. And another option is place three in front of the mental foramen.
Three, okay.
And only one in the molar region.
Molar region.
So any combination will work out. And if you see, the inferior alveolar nerve is not very much visible.
It's not visible.
It's very thin. And it is almost disappearing into the bone.
Correct.
So that tells the bone quality is not very good.
Okay.
So osteoporotic cases, it is difficult to see the inferior alveolar
cavity. Okay.
So we may have to take IOPA or CBCT.
Okay.
And the mental foramen is visible here below the second premolar. And here also the mental foramen is visible here. Immediately below the second premolar. So it is better to avoid these two areas.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. And in the first premolar, there is a periapical infection. Okay. And this first premolar also is a periapical infection. So it is better to use a BCS.
Okay.
Than a KOS.
Yeah.
Of course, we are planning for a alveoloplasty here.
Okay.
So whenever you are doing alveoloplasty, it is almost till the root apex of all the tooth anteriors.
Okay.
To remove all thin bones and to make it flat and to create a even line, even thickness for processes. So it's a must. Alveoloplasty is a must for this case. Skipping the alveoloplasty is the most common mistake we do in the beginning stages of learning. So a must for lower full mouth is, you have to decide whether
there is a problem in placing the teeth there, no?
Yes, otherwise we will get problem in prosthetic stage.
Okay.
Now we will see the CBCT now. Now we will see the each and every tooth.
Okay.
We will first see the interforamina area, that is the most critical area. We will see the midline.
Okay.
You can see the midline vascular canal, lingual vessels. Okay. One black line going inside and one black coming outside. But it's very small. So of course midline you are not going to do anything. So the bone quality is good.
Okay.
The anteriors.
Okay.
The bone quality is very cortical. So this is the canine area. This is the canine.
Okay.
So canine is the strategic area. Canine, it is better to place implant. If you closely observe, immediately below the canine, the bone is quite okay. But here it is fully cancellous. And lower border is cortical. If you place BCS in this case, you will get stability here, but as you go deeper, suddenly the implant will become loose.
Okay.
You got the point?
Yes.
The BCS will catch the bone below the apex, but when it goes here, it is more porous, it will become loose. Then you must drill till the lower border and you have to catch.
Better
to avoid the BCS here.
Okay.
If you place KOS, it will compress the bone.
Okay.
Because it's a compression screw and it will get stability. You don't have to go and catch the thing.
So, if there's any cancerous bone, then better go for a
case. Better go for it. If you want to place BCS, you have to drill
this
cortical, which is not needed.
Not needed.
Why you want to unnecessarily do it? Okay, so the lower anterior, these areas, it is better to.
Suppose the bone, cortical bone, buccal bone is damaged.
Damaged.
That case, can we go
then you have to use the BCS or use a BCS
EX.
Here also the bone quality is good here.
Okay,
you can do it.
Okay, BCS EX is that in between that
yes. So there is a lesion here.
Okay.
So now we are moving into the right molar area.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is the right molar area. The ridge is very thin.
Okay.
The ridge is very thin. So there is no ridge width here. It is only 4.4 mm. Adenoidal, it is very difficult to place it here, right?
Adenoidal,
you cannot place. Conventional, it is difficult to place because it is very thinner. But KOS, you can place on small KOS, 10 mm. 3.2 also you can select.
Okay.
3.2 mm or 3.7 also you can select, it will expand the crest of the ridge.
3.7
is okay. 3.7 into 10 will be fine. And one more option is, so the ridge is thin, right? Very sharp knife edge. So one option is go through the knife edge ridge.
Or flatten it and then do it.
And don't try flattening at all. Okay. Already the bone, there is no need for flattening.
Okay.
Because if you flatten, you will be removing the good quality C1 bone.
Okay.
That is problem. Otherwise, you can tilt lingually. Take engagement from the lingual cortex. So we are getting this lingual shelf even in first molar area in this patient. Usually we get this lingual shelf in second molar, but here we are getting in first molar itself. So you can do the lingual cortical engagement even in first molar area in this, for this patient, not for always.
Okay.
So from here to here, okay, that is the option we are having now. Okay. From buccal to lingual. Start the drilling buccally, keep one finger lingually,
okay,
and perforate the lingual plate. And if you see here, the lingual plate is not very thick.
Okay.
So if you use BCS, you will be getting support only from this thin lingual cortical plate.
Okay.
So the stability may not be good.
Okay.
So it is better to use a KOS,
yes,
which will get stability from this buccal cortex, from the medullary bone,
okay,
from the lingual cortex also. So the tentative length will be around 10.
10, okay.
3.7-10 will be ideal.
Straight also is ideal.
But the straight problem is the ridge is thin, knife edge, the drill may slip.
Uh-huh.
This kind of problem is there, and you are getting stability only from the C1 crestal cortical and the intramedullary bone.
Mm-hmm.
But if you tilt lingually, you are getting bone from three zones.
Mm-hmm.
So any mandible here in the molar, mm-hmm, you are getting three zones. One is the crestal cortical, second is the intramedullary bone, the third, mm-hmm, one is the lingual cortical. If you do lingual cortical engagement, you will be getting stability from all the three zones. So better to use a KOS.
So use adding in this case, it'd be a failure.
I don't know. You have
because
to
4.2, 3.7. That's a 3.7.
Because the ridge width is very thin, the rough threads will get exposed.
Mm.
Right, you may need to do some bone graft.
Grafting.
Yeah,
I'm not sure. We have to do grafting.
Okay. So even till 7, the right side, this is the right side. Even till 7, the lingual shelf is very wide.
Good. Mm.
Right. Even you can observe, appreciate here, no? The 3D image.
Mm-hmm.
See the lingual shelf. Mm-hmm. It's the myeloid ridge. This is the lingual shelf. It's excellent here.
Mm-hmm.
Even though the ridge is thin.
Okay. Yeah.
The ridge is thin, no? Can you see the ridge is very thin? But we are getting the lingual shelf very good. Even from the...
This is the myeloid ridge.
Yes. Okay. From the first molar area, it is starting. On left side also, we are getting good lingual shelf here.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So both side, we can do lingual cortical
it should go beneath the myeloid ridge, right?
Yes, below the myeloid ridge.
Okay. Above means it'll be a problem.
Yeah, above means tongue will feel it.
So how do you guide it correctly with this?
You have to keep one finger on the lingual shelf here.
Okay.
You have to keep the finger on the lingual shelf.
And then direct it like
and,
this.
Yes. Try to touch your finger.
Yes.
So here, the right molar, either one or two lingual cortical engaged KOS. Okay, and anteriorly to KOS, okay, or BCS depending upon the situation.
But normally it is healed, in this case bone is good,
yeah,
better go for KOS.
KOS, when the buccolingual width is good,
okay,
you can go for KOS. When the labial plate is missing or some infection,
that
is
interesting.
Yes, you can go for okay. And now we are seeing the left side.
There also a lesion.
Yes. This is the second premolar area. We have to avoid the area.
Okay.
Because the nerve is closer. Now behind, in the sixth area, we are seeing the cross section. The ridge is also very thin, but not very thin as we see on the right side.
Okay.
The right side, then it is knife edged. Here there is some width is there. Around 5 and all. So you can use a 3.7 into 10
mm.
Right? 10 mm. Or if you are doubtful about the canal, you can use a 3.78.
8 is also okay.
8 is also okay. But here you will be getting support only from the crestal cortical and the little bit of porous intramedullary bone.
Okay.
Now when we are going slightly more distal,
okay,
near the 7-8 region, now we are getting the lingual shelf.
Okay,
the lingual shelf. And the width is also good. So you can place a implant engaging here. Or you can place the implant like this also. So you can.
There's a Newton canal, sir.
Yes, this is a Newton canal. This is like this is a Newton canal.
The big one, that is a Newton canal.
So either a small implant, 3.7 10,
okay,
straight, or just angle it. If you get lingual cortical engagement, it will be an excellent one.
Yeah. How do you identify if there is a nutrient canal or a...
It's a nutrient canal only because it is crossing the lingual cortex.
Okay.
But we don't have to worry about it. Okay, so now we are getting a good width just in front of the 7. So whenever a standing tooth is there, immediately mesial or distal to it, the width will be good.
Okay, adjust the...
Yes. That is one secret.
Okay. No, I didn't.
Whenever a standing tooth is there, okay, immediately adjacent to it, the width will be good.
Okay.
I will show you now. So this is 7.
Okay.
Okay. See the width immediately adjacent to the 7. Okay.
Okay.
Now we are in the middle of 6. Now see the width. Since tooth is there, it retains the bone surrounding it. Okay.
So when you're placing the implant, it should be near the Yes. Should be near
close that. To the 7.
Close to the
close 7. To the 7, if you go, you will get good width.
Okay.
If you do it in the middle 6, the bone width is very less. So it's a straightforward case except for the right molar. Except for the right molar where the ridge is thin, extremely thin, right? It's very sharp. Definitely we have to use a lingual cortical engagement. 3.7 or 3.2, whatever it is. Apart from that, it is just a protocol.